Get ready to match the stars. Tom Bosley, Brett Summers, Gary Berghoff, Meredith McRae, Richard Dawson, and Patty Flagg as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 75. And now here's the star of Match Game 75, Gene Rivers.
It's Fanny's nice present to me for Easter. Do you think she hates me?
Madam, you are ugly.
Here, let's swap.
Oh, no.
Gene, just let me know when it stops moving.
Okay, wait, I don't all want right. To... Already
done. Imagine her giving me that thing for Easter and wanting me to wear it to church.
Okay, now let's say hello to our two players over here, Louise Miller and Nancy Day. Hello, ladies.
How are you?
Now, Louise is our current champion. You have won $2,500, and you're being challenged by Nancy Day, and we finished one round.
I'm only doing this for one reason. I couldn't stand looking at it.
Sir? You, too, are ugly.
Yes, but I know it.
I think it's a very cheap way to get a laugh.
Oh, well.
All right, there. Put it right there. Now, we finished round one, and the score is 2-0 in favor of Nancy Day, right? You ready for round two? Okay, round two coming up, but first, we got a message for you. This is it. Are you ready?
Okay, ladies.
Here we go. It's the latest. Push this little button right here.
Terrific.
Bing! There it is.
Didn't I see you on a can of salt?
Middle round two. Louise, you've got to score two matches to stay in the game. Three, however, will win another game for you.
And they said Garbo would never make another pick.
Yeah. Everybody play.
Okay.
It's a serious moment for Louise.
All right. Sure.
Virginia said, "My baby is so ugly that when my mother came to visit, she took one look at him and tossed him a blank."
I hate that question. I love babies. There's no such thing as an ugly baby.
Virginia said, "My baby is so ugly that when my mother came to visit, she took one look at him and tossed him a blank." You got the idea?
Mm-hmm.
You got the idea. Right.
I love you in white sparkles.
Thanks.
You look just like Harold Teen.
Yes.
What are you doing after the show?
Sorry, Richard asked me first.
I don't mind. You be what you like. I don't care.
All right, now let's all use our deep voices. And Louise.
I don't care.
Virginia said, "My baby is so ugly that when my mother came to visit, she took one look at him and tossed him a..."
Banana.
A banana. She said, "Tossed him a banana." Tom, what'd you say?
Awful. I said a mirror.
Oh, that's very... As you know...
That's what my mother did.
Mr. Bosley, as some of you may remember, did a marvelous Broadway show called Fiorello about the great mayor of New York called Fiorello LaGuardia, and he was marvelous in the part. And one of the statements Mr. LaGuardia made at one point when he appointed a judge who was convicted of bribery, when the reporters were asking him about him, that statement applies, I think, to you, Tom, at this moment. He says, "I don't often make a mistake, but when I do, it's a beaut." Thanks
you
for that.
Have to be there,
yeah,
really.
That's right. All right, Brett.
That was funny, Gene.
Yeah.
It wasn't bad. Put your hat back on.
Yes.
I go on record as saying I don't like that question because I love babies. I know that may sound odd to the world, but I love babies. But I hate this bloody hat.
Yes.
I said bone.
Toss him a bone. Virginia said, my baby is so ugly that when my mother came to visit, she took one look at him and tossed him a blank. And she said banana.
I don't have the slightest idea. I didn't understand the question or anything, but I said banana.
A banana. You need one more to stay in the game, Louise. Let's see if we get a banana out of you.
This is really terrible. I said she took one look at him and tossed him across the room.
And you're a mother!
And you a new mother?
I'm sorry.
Have you thought of taking up tennis or something to work out your unresolved hostilities?
She has a six-month-old baby made out of rubber.
Yeah. All right.
That reminds me of the words of Mayor LaGuardia, who once said, as he threw a baby across the room, I don't often make a mistake, but when I do, it's usually a banana.
Nice score. One more banana wins the game, lady. Banana! Fancy meeting you here. Okay. Now, Nancy Day, we've got a gift for you, together with our thanks for being with us.
I had a great time.
Well, it was a short visit, but we enjoyed meeting you. Nancy Day, goodbye. Got a message for you here, and then you come right back. Here we are for the fifth time with Louise Miller. Can you believe she's been up and down here five times? She's won five games, and all she has is $2,600. You haven't won the $5,000 once yet, have you?
No, I haven't.
You going to do it this time?
I'm sure going to try.
All right. Now, we polled a recent studio audience, Louise, and we got their best response to this. Blank twins. Blank twins. Okay, the answer they gave most often is worth $500. Next one, $250. And the third one, $100. Whom do you call on?
Richard.
Siamese twins.
Siamese twins, one.
Fanny. Pardon?
Yes.
Identical twins.
Identical twins.
Gary.
I'm sorry, yeah. I didn't hear Richard's.
He said Siamese twins and identical twins.
Bobsey twins.
Bobsey twins. All right. You got the Bobsey twins, the Siamese twins, and identical twins. Now, what do you want to do with that? You want to pick one of those?
Oh, I think I'll try Siamese. Yeah.
Siamese twins. That's one Richard gave you. We'll find out if it's up there, and if so, where. First, may we see the $100 response. Bobsey twins is up there. That's one that Gary gave you.
Gary,
and here we go. Still looking for Siamese twins. May we see the $250 response. Identical twins. So far, you got two out of three. This might be your lucky shot at it. We'll find out right now. Last chance for the Siamese twins. Here's the $500 response. You got it. Okay. Congratulations. Good for you. Now, Louise, you're up to $3,100. Now you got a chance at the $5,000. And remember, to get it, you got to match one celebrity. Which one will it be?
Richard.
Richard who? Richard Dawson over there. I see.
The only time I ever matched was, I think, the first time she played.
That's right.
We've got to do it this time, okay? Think of the first thing.
$5,000 right here. You face me?
Mm-hmm.
A little more?
Mm-hmm.
Ivan Blank. I-V-A-N. Ivan Blank. All right, Louise, he has finished. Now we ask you to fill in the blank to match him. How do you do that to match him? Ivan?
Ho.
Ho. Ho, ho, ho. Richard, I know you're not too familiar with English literature, but she said Ivan Ho.
Ask me anything you like. You said what, my
She dog? Said Ivanhoe will match you for $5,000. What do you say to that?
I just guess it's not your... Oh, yes, it is your week.
Ivanhoe!
$1,100.
How about that?
Oh, it's terrific.
Terrific. What do you do with all that money?
Spend it.
Still gonna spend it. Boy, it's really piling up. $8,100 for Louise Miller. It's the first time she's won the $5,000, and she's very. Now, where are your friends out there?
They're not here. They're in Colorado Springs.
Well, everybody, you don't have any friends or relatives or anybody out there?
No.
Oh, well.
All right. We're all your friends, right. Darling.
Yeah. Friendly bunch. Now, let's bring out another player. Here comes Travis Williams. There's a little souvenir for you, okay? Hello there, Travis. How are you?
All right.
Now, when the merry-go-round stops, you can get aboard, Louise. You know Travis Williams, I guess. Very sharp-looking suit there, Travis.
I'm trying to follow after my idol.
Well, I thank you very much. Where's Travis Williams from?
Phoenix, Arizona.
Phoenix, Arizona.
Right. Been out here about 4 years, though.
Yeah.
And finishing up my last semester in law school at Loyola University. And I'm a bachelor.
You are?
Yeah.
Law school is hard, isn't it?
Yeah, it takes a lot of time.
Yeah.
It takes a lot.
You got all that stuff in your head now, huh?
I hope so.
I hope so, too. Well, good luck. I hope you make a little money here so you can help pay for your law studies. Let's begin by asking you to make a selection.
B.
Everybody plays. New game. The warden said to the rock and roll singer, "Kid, before we take you to the electric chair, do you have a last request?" And the rock and roll singer says, "Yeah, man. You have a chair that's extra large? I'd like to bring along my blank." Do I'd like to bring along my blank. Man, I want a big chair, because I'm going to bring along my blank. In D flat.
Well, what do you,
are you
have
ready?
In mind?
Gary!
Yes, sir.
You're holding up the electrocution.
I couldn't help it. Her turtle crawled over my car.
I have a call on Travis Williams. The warden said to the rock and roll singer, "Kid, before we take you to the electric chair, do you have a last request?" And the rock and roll singer says, "Yeah, man, do you have a chair that's extra large? I'd like to bring along my blank."
Guitar.
My guitar. He said guitar. What do you say, Tom?
I, too, said guitar.
Guitar. That's one for you, Travis. And Brett.
Well, there are many alternatives.
Yes. He gave one good one.
Well, what the hell? Me too, guitar.
Guitar. Okay, that's two guitars.
You don't need...
Two guitars.
You don't need an extra large chair for a guitar. You need them for the drums.
The drums. Okay. So we have two guitars and a drum. Let's see what this little lady offers.
I said guitar.
She offers you a guitar, Travis. Do I? What do you say?
Do I?
I'd say let's get out of here, man.
Okay.
We're in the farmer's market. Wheel.
Oh, I'm sorry. I just dozed off. The guitar would be in your lap, Travis.
Right.
Although he has a lovely airfield. I thought a large chair so the guy could bring along his group.
His group.
We'll all go
That's
together.
That's right. We sing together and fry together. What do you say?
I said group.
Good.
Group. So we have two groups, two guitars, and assorted things there. All right, Travis, you did fairly well with that. What do you got there, three? Now let's see how you do with yours, Louise. Your first round question, I have a little riddle for you.
Oh.
What has four legs and a trunk and sits on the roof of your house? The answer, an elephant who thinks he's a blank.
I give up.
No, I'm not going to read it again. One shot at it is all you get. Now, what has four legs and a trunk and sits on the roof of your house? The answer, an elephant who thinks he's a blank.
What are those little things that sit on the roofs of houses?
Well,
be quiet.
Oh, I know what they are.
You got it?
Don't
you can
worry
whisper
about
in
me.
My ear if you like, and I...
No, I know exactly what it is.
Okay.
That is.
Okay.
Put it in the slot.
Are you sure?
Well...
This part.
Okay.
Well, I was deliver.
Now, everybody ready with a little riddle here. Louise Miller. What has four legs and a trunk and sits on the roof of your house? The answer, an elephant who thinks he's a blank.
A chimney.
An elephant who thinks he's a chimney. You've done it again, you rascal.
Okay. Tom?
I don't know why you thought it was a lousy answer, so did I.
Oh! You've been doing that all week. That's incredible.
She and I are in tune.
Listen, matching answers can be lousy sometimes.
That's right.
That doesn't count, good or lousy. All right, Brett.
No. Do you know those little weather vanes?
Yep.
And they're called roosters.
Roosters, okay.
Give her her hat back.
If you've never lived in the country and you don't know about that stuff, that's not my problem.
All right, Gary.
Imagine what she had on the roof of her house.
Go ahead.
Shh.
That's a marvelous imitation of a pigeon. What has four legs and a trunk sits on the roof of your house? The answer, an elephant who thinks he's a blank. What do you say?
I was just going to apologize for my answer, but I go along with Gary. I said pigeon.
So you got two pigeons so far. Two pigeons, one chimney, and one weather vane. And you, sir.
Very good answer. Yeah. You have any messages for me?
I love it.
Send this back. Oh, I'm sorry. I must get off. I was going to say rooster, but I said weather vane.
Weather vane.
Right, thank you, Richard.
Two weather vanes so far.
I want to make you look good.
Fanny.
Cheaper than plastic surgery.
Fanny.
Hello. Hello, America. I said TV antenna because I thought that made
sense. Very good. Very good answer. So the round has ended, round one, and it's 3-1 in favor of Travis, and round two follows round one. Isn't that interesting? Watch this message. Aw. Hey, be around. Hey, we're just talking here. Now, Travis, up to you. A or B?
I'll take B again.
B again. Now, you matched three last time, so that means only three play this time. They are Gary, Richard, and Fanny. This is for you. It is a little-known fact of history that Cleopatra was a jewel smuggler. Now, you didn't know that. But this is a very educational program. You find out all kinds of things here. Just before she left Egypt, Cleopatra stuffed her blank full of diamonds. Yeah.
Now, wait
a minute. Oh, I have such a wonderful answer for that. I wish I was.
Come here, Gene.
I'm not surprised.
Okay, sure. All right, everybody ready here?
I had mine ready.
All right, Travis Williams. Did you? It is a little known fact of history that Cleopatra was a jewel smuggler. Just before she left Egypt, Cleopatra stuffed her blank full of diamonds. Think about it for a second and then give us your response.
Asp.
Her asp.
Same to you, fella.
The lawyer said asp.
Hmm?
The lawyer said asp. What does the kid say?
What, do you
want
to make a federal case out of it?
No, I said navel.
Stuffed her navel full of diamonds.
Everybody knows all those women over there are belly dancers.
All right. Richard Dawson.
Brett played Cleopatra once.
Did she play Cleopatra?
A great review. It said, last night, Brett barged down the Nile and sank.
Asp. Okay, Travis, I'll give you four. Now let's see if this little lady with the funny hat makes it five.
What is on me?
Oh!
Look at this.
Look at that.
And you know what I wrote?
What did you write?
Apple. No, I wrote asp.
Asp. So now that means he's got five, and that means you've got to match four to... Oh, no. Hold everything here now. Well, you got to be. We got to stop right here for a second, or maybe this is it. The end of the show about? Oh, we're getting close to the end. All right, do this message and come right back, and we'll talk. Hello. How are you? Nice to see you. How do you do? Listen, I'm sorry we've run out of time. I thought we had a little more time to play some game, but we don't. We just got a minute or so here. I want to thank you and look forward to seeing you next time. Score is 5-1. You got to do some going there to catch up with him, all right? Happy days, Tom. Thank you for being with us.
Thank you for having
me. Nice to see your body again in all its splendor. And you.
Yeah.
When was the Battle of Hastings? You know so much about English history.
The date of it? I got no idea.
1066.
When?
1066.
What century did King Richard rule England in?
I got no idea.
Well, listen, let me explain. I don't mind you asking these questions, because otherwise, you know, if you don't ask, you'll never learn, will you?
No, I won't.
You forgot it.
Okay, we hope you're going to be able to join us next time when we will have this assortment of people who were recently released from the Funny Farm.
Charlie Brill, Brett Summers, Jerry Berghoff, Sarah Kennedy, Richard Dawson, and Betty White.
This is Gene Rayburn, Match Game 75, and we hope you will be able to join us next time for Have a Ball. Thank you.
This is Johnny Olsen speaking for Match Game 75. A Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. Stay tuned for Tattletales next over most of these CBS stations.